Hell to Pay is right, and there they are.
Oh, yeah.
Triple H and Mr. McMahon have gathered their troops. It looks like they're on their way here to the ring. Stay tuned for this explosion.
One, two, is this on?
We are back live in the sold-out Nassau Coliseum. As we suspected, and the handheld regime will soon be making their way to ringside. And King, you gotta believe that there are some individuals here that have huge marks on their person in the form of retribution by these individuals here tonight.
Oh, you got that right. There are certain individuals that I certainly wouldn't want to be tonight. Need I name names?
We saw just moments ago the out-of-control nature of SmackDown last Thursday night.
We know none of that would have taken place if it hadn't been for, well, people like Jericho sticking his nose where it didn't belong. People like Rikishi, those damn Dudleys.
Ladies,
they had no business bothering the McMahon healthy regime.
Strength in numbers. This group has the intellect and the muscle, not only physical muscle, but corporate muscle, to do just about anything that they want to do. Certainly our best wishes go out to referee Earl Hebner, who is still recuperating from that assault, that gang beating that he sustained.
Yeah. But let me talk about something important. Does Triple H look a little weird without the WWF Championship belt around his waist? This doesn't look right, does it?
I'll reserve my comments for a later time.
You know, first things first, I'd like to come out here and apologize a little bit to everybody for the actions of Earl Hebner.
Oh, good. What did he do wrong? Everything.
You see, I know that you're all aware of the tragedy that has befallen Earl Hebner, the vicious beating he received and all. When the World Wrestling Federation has something like that happen in it, it's flooded, it's inundated with phone calls, with letters, with cards. And Earl Hebner has been he's just not been able to respond.
Don't get the game upset, please.
Earl Hebner has not been able to respond to your well wishes like a true World Wrestling Federation superstar should. And I'm out here to explain to you that, you know, it's not Earl's fault. It's very difficult to make a phone call back to somebody when your little jaw is wired shut and broken and you can't speak. And it's really difficult to return a letter or a card when your eyes are so swollen shut that you can't read the paper in front of you. And even if you could, your little broken nubby fingers can't even hold the pen to write back.
What's funny about that? This is a great moment.
I mean, it's not his fault. And it truly is a tragedy. And the worst part is that the whole thing could have been avoided if Earl Hebner would have just kept his nose out of our business.
See what I told you?
But no, Earl's got to get involved. Earl's got to be the big hero, the big star. Well, Earl got what he deserved. And as a public service announcement to everybody else in the World Wrestling Federation, I would like to show you what happens when you cross the McMahon-Helmsley regime. So Kevin Dunn,
uh-oh,
roll the footage.
Oh, this is not gonna be pretty.
Not right. Like Earl's a trophy. Look at the poor Earl. Bleeding profusely. He was 140 pounds in his hometown, getting humiliated before his family.
family. And not what few teeth he had left out. Look at his mouth.
Look at Earl.
Wheeled out on a
stretcher.
So
you want to be a hero, huh?
Shame.
Well, let that be a lesson. You cross us, you stand in my path of doing the one thing that is inevitable, and that is me becoming the World Wrestling Federation champion, and that is what happens.
He's obsessed. It's the game of regaining the WWE title.
Which brings me to The Rock.
Uh-oh. He's the WWE champion. The Rock.
Rock, Judgment Day is coming. And true to form, all truths will be told at Judgment Day. It will all come to a head, and everybody will know the truth, Rock. Judgment Day. You and me, Rock, one-on-one with the one thing that anybody worth a crap in this business wants more than anything, the World Wrestling Federation Championship on the line. Only this time, Rock, things will be a little different. There will be no Stone Cold Steve Austin. There will be no Linda McMahon. And there will be no little piece of crap Earl Hebner sticking his nose where it doesn't belong.
This should be fair this time. Oh.
There will just be me and you, Rock. But what I propose is, let's up the ante. Let's separate the men from the boys, Rock.
Uh-oh.
Let's find out who is the general in this ring. Let's go the one place that very few people in this business will ever dream of going, Rock. That all those guys in the back are scared to death to ever try and do.
What's he talking about?
Rock, you and me. Iron Man match.
What?
60 minutes, Rock. Let's find out who the man is. Can you go the distance? 60 minutes. The one with the most falls is the undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion.
Wow. That's less than 2 weeks away.
But you gotta look inside, Rock, and you've gotta ask yourself, can I hang? Because I know I can. Can you hang, Rock? Can you step into this ring and go 1 hour with the game?
It's a long time. Amazing.
Can you, Rock, put it all on the line and hope to God that your lungs don't explode before the end? And can you accept the fact, Rock, that the truth will be told, that when you lay on that mat, gasping for air after 60 minutes of getting your ass kicked by the best in this damn business, you will look into my eyes and you will know once and for all that you can't hang with me because I have no equal. Rock, you will know once and for all that I am the game, that I am the World Wrestling Federation champion.